Welcome to a review on multiplying and dividing integers. For the examples, we will be using the formal rules for multiplying and dividing integers shown below, where when multiplying or dividing two integers with the same sign, the result is always positive, and when multiplying or dividing two integers with different signs, the result is always negative. Looking at the first example, we need to recognize that a fraction bar means division. This quotient is 8 divided by 1. Because both integers have the same sign, 8 divided by 1 equals positive 8. The next quotient is negative 8 divided by positive 1. Because the two integers have different signs, this quotient is negative 8. The next quotient is negative 8 divided by negative 8. Both integers have the same sign, this quotient equals positive 1. Next, we have a product. We can read this as negative negative 8 times 0, or the opposite of negative 8 times 0, and the opposite of negative 8 is positive 8. This product is equivalent to positive 8 times 0, which means we have 8 copies of 0, which equals 0. When multiplying two numbers, and one or both numbers are 0, the product will always be 0. Next, we would read this as the opposite of positive 8 divided by negative 1, which we can also write as negative and then in parentheses 8 divided by negative 1. Positive 8 divided by negative 1 is negative 8. This is equal to the opposite of negative 8, which is equal to positive 8. So the opposite of positive 8 divided by negative 1 is equal to positive 8. But I also want to mention, when we have a negative out in front of a fraction bar, we can place that negative in the numerator or denominator. So the opposite of 8 divided by negative 1 is equivalent to, if we move the negative up to the numerator, this would be negative 8 divided by negative 1, which is also positive 8. The next quotient is negative 8 divided by 0, which is asking us to take negative 8 and divide it into 0 equally sized parts or groups, which is not possible, which is one reason why division by 0 is undefined, and we're told to enter DNE. Another way to better understand why division by 0 is undefined is to write the corresponding product for this quotient. This quotient is negative 8 divided by 0 equals some value. If this quotient exists, then there must be some number times 0 equal to negative 8. And because there's no number times 0 equal to negative 8, this is another explanation as to why division by 0 is undefined. The next quotient is negative 8 divided by positive 8. The two integers have different signs, and therefore negative 8 divided by positive 8 equals negative 1. Next, we have positive 8 divided by negative 8. But again, we're dividing two integers with different signs. The result must be negative. This quotient is also negative 1. Looking at the next quotient, we would read this as the opposite of positive 8 divided by negative 8, which means you can write this as the opposite of, and then in parentheses, positive 8 divided by negative 8. Inside the parentheses, the two integers have different signs. This quotient is negative 1, so this is the opposite of negative 1, which is equal to positive 1. So the given quotient is equal to positive 1, or, again, if we wanted to, we could move the negative up to the numerator. This quotient is equivalent to negative 8 divided by negative 8, which is also equal to positive 1. Next, we have the opposite of 0 divided by 8, which we would write as negative and then parentheses 0 divided by 8. One interpretation of 0 divided by 8 is to take 0 and break it up into 8 equally sized parts or groups, which would still be 0, and the opposite of 0 is still 0. We can also interpret 0 divided by 8 as asking how many 8s there are in 0. There are 0 8s in 0, and therefore the quotient is 0. Next, we have negative 8 times negative 1. The two integers have the same sign. The product is positive. Negative 8 times negative 1 equals positive 8. And then finally, we have 0 times 8, which means that 0 copies of 8, which equals 0, or again, when multiplying two integers or two numbers, if one or both numbers are equal to 0, the product is always 0. I hope you found this helpful.